Simon P. Sapioper is Minister of Foreign Affairs of the National Government of the Republic of West Papua and member of the Papua National Party and the Free Papua Movement. West Papua is the western part of the island New Guinea and home to over 240 different peoples and languages of Melanesian origin. Following its independence from the Netherlands, West Papua was annexed by Indonesia. Ever since, the West Papuans faced severe abuses, destruction of resources, and murder at the hands of the Indonesian army. West Papuan peoples salute the same flag and have drafted a common constitution. Raising this flag is considered a criminal offense by Indonesia, who has blacklisted the Free Papua Movement and its Liberation Army as terrorist organizations.
Untuk menyatakan aspirasi rakyat Melanesia di Papua Barat bekas Netherlands New Guinea. Sejak memperdebatkan wilayah-wilayah yang diakibatkan konflik-konflik sepanjang sejarah, itu kiranya menandai pokok memperdebatkan wilayah-wilayah di dunia yang mencari kemerdekaan. Dan mereka pada saat ini dalam bentuk negara-negara yang tidak diakui. Demikian, satu negara yang tidak diakui adalah Papua Barat, bekas Netherlands New Guinea.
Since disputed territories have often been the cause of the conflict throughout history, it seems appropriate to feature the principal dispute territories of the world that seek independence and are currently in the form of unrecognized states. Such an unrecognized state is West Papua, the former Netherlands New Guinea.
Sejarah ringkas. Izinkanlah kami mulai dengan sejarah ringkas dari negeri kami. Papua Barat tidak mempunyai hubungan dengan Indonesia. Secara ilmu bumi, Papua Barat terletak di samping Papua New Guinea, membentuk sebelah barat dari pulau kekayaan dari New Guinea, sekitar 300 km dari utara ujung Australia. Penduduk aslinya mempunyai akar Melanesia. Membuat adat istiadat, mereka dan secara kebangsaan sama dengan saudara sebangsa di Papua New Guinea, tetapi tidak dengan Indonesia.
Let me start with a brief history of our country. West Papua had no ties with Indonesia. Geographically, West Papua sits beside Papua New Guinea, forming the western half of the resource-rich island of New Guinea, about 300 kilometers from the northern tip of Australia. Its indigenous people have Melanesian roots, making them culturally and ethnically similar to their counterparts in Papua New Guinea, but not to Indonesians.
Dr. Muhammad Atta, bekas wakil presiden Indonesia pertama, menyatakan di Perserikatan Bangsa-Bangsa pada 11 Juli 1945. Pribadi saya menyatakan bahwa saya tidak mau ambil pusing sekali tentang Papua. Hal ini dibicarakan kepada orang-orang Papua sendiri. Saya mengakui bahwa rakyat Papua juga mempunyai hak menjadi satu bangsa yang merdeka. Pada 17 Agustus 1945, Dr. Soekarno dan Dr. Muhammad Atta secara sepihak proklamasi Federasi Republik Indonesia Serikat, RIS, New Guinea Barat, tidak disebut.
Dr. Muhammad Hatta, former first vice president of Indonesia, stated at the United Nations on 11 July 1945. Personally, I am quite willing to state that I do not bother at all about Papua. That can be left to the Papuans themselves. I recognize that the people of Papua too have the right to become a free nation. On 17 August 1945, Dr. Soekarno and Dr. Muhammad Hatta unilaterally proclaimed the Federation of the United Republic of Indonesia. West New Guinea was not mentioned.
Pada hari yang sama, pada jam 8 malam waktu setempat di Papua, Markus Kesiepo dipilih oleh pemimpin-pemimpin Papua memberitahukan pemerintah kerajaan Belanda lewat Wakil Konika, Commanding Official of the Netherlands Indies Civil Administration, bahwa rakyat Papua tidak menjadi bagian Federasi Republik Indonesia. Di tahun 1949, pada waktu Dutch East Indies, India Belanda Timur, mendapat kemerdekaan penuh sebagai Indonesia, Belanda menerima kedaulatan atas New Guinea Barat, Netherlands New Guinea, dan mengambil langkah-langkah persiapan itu untuk kemerdekaan sebagai satu negeri terpisah.
On the same day at 8 o'clock p.m. local time in Papua, Markus Kesiepo was chosen by the West Papuan leaders to inform the government of the Dutch kingdom through the intermediary of Konika, commanding officer of the Netherlands Indies Civil Administration, that the West Papuan people would not become part of the Federal Republic of Indonesia. In 1949, the rest of the Dutch East Indies became full independent as Indonesia. The Dutch retained sovereignty over West New Guinea and took steps to prepare it for independence as a separate country. President Sukarno and all subsequent Indonesian presidents knew full well that when our country was handed over to Indonesia by United Nations Temporary Executive Administration on 1 May 1963, that Indonesia's claim was groundless. The fact is that 99.5% of the native inhabitants of Melanesian origin in West Papua want independence. The Indonesian government knew perfectly well that a referendum in West Papua would have resulted in our country becoming independent. By continuing annexation and occupation of West Papua, Indonesia is operating contradiction of the letter and the spirit of its constitution. Independence is the inalienable right of all nations. Therefore, all colonialism must be abolished in this world, as it is not in conformity with humanity and justice. At 30 September 2009, cable from the U.S. Embassy in Jakarta described the situation in West Papua after half a century of Indonesian occupation as follows. Papua has enormous natural resources wealth. Despite this wealth, Papuan remain poor. The region lags behind the rest of Indonesia in virtually all development indicators. Healthcare and education are severely underdeveloped, particularly for ethnic Papuans. The region HIV/AIDS infection rate is far over the national average, and diseases like malaria and tuberculosis are widespread. Malnutrition is common, especially in remote highlands areas. Papuan schools are often poorly equipped, and teachers are frequently absent. Poor infrastructures hampers effort to address these deficits. There are very few roads in the vast and mountainous regions, and many villages can be reached in small aircraft. All these factors feed Papuan resentment. The following component will make up the West Papuan state in much the same way as other nations are composed. One, the territory, the former territory of Netherlands, New Guinea. Two, the nation, a Melanesian nation that live in West Papua, former Netherlands, New Guinea. Three, the government, the revolutionary provisional government of the Republic of West Papua, later renamed the National Government of Republic of West Papua. The National Government of the Republic of West Papua, with the support of UNPO, will issue identity card for the members of OPM, or citizen of West Papua. This is a sample of the ID card. In this way, we will register the freedom fighters and Papuan people. On 1st July 1971, the leader organization Papua Merdeka unilaterally proclaimed West Papua the Papuan name of the territory of the former Netherlands New Guinea as an independent democratic republic. This was the desire of the people of West Papua that was expressed in the letter and the spirit of the unilateral proclamation, 1st July 1971. To the Papuan people, from Numbai up to Merauke, from Sorong to Balim, the Star Mountains, and from Biak up to the island of Adi, by the grace and assistance of God, we have today been given the opportunity to let it be known to you all, in conformity with the sincere will of the Papuan people, that as from today, 1st July 1971, the people and the country of West Papua have become independent and enjoy full sovereignty, de facto and de jure. May God be with us, and may the world hereby learn that the noble striving of the Papuan people after becoming a free nation in its own country of West Papua has now become a fact. The unilateral proclamation was made 4 days before the first democratic general election in Indonesia on 5th July 1971. Thereby rejecting any participation in Indonesian policy to keep West Papua within the United States Republic of Indonesia. This was our declaration, and the way we rejected the result of the Act of Free Choice 1969, which brought catastrophe and destruction to the Papuan Negroid race Melanesian on this earth. Constitution without independence. Before forming the executive body and legislative body, we form a committee to draft the provisional constitution. This committee worked for 18 months to prepare the provisional constitution in the jungle without any guidance. This constitution will come under the consideration of the first elected parliament chosen by the Papuan people via the first general election after achieving diplomatic recognition as a sovereignty state. Preamble. With the protection and assistance of God Almighty, creator of this world, the West Papuan people have arrived at this happy moment, generation after generation, throughout human history, to become a nation state with full independence and sovereignty among the nations of the world. Indeed, the State of Republic of West Papua, which is based on Christian brotherly love, honors and guarantees fundamental human rights, freedom, democracy, and justice, and dedicates itself to the prosperity and happiness of its people, while taking active part in the effort of the world peace. This constitution has 129 articles and consists of 8 parts. The constitution is the basis of the creation of the State of Republic of West Papua as a democratic one among all the nations in the world, whereas the Charter of Organisasi Papua Merdeka regulates the national movement from 3 political parties struggling to achieve an independent and sovereign state of West Papua. Tension regarding the Dutch Indies in Indonesian dispute over Netherlands New Guinea were escalating in December 1957, following Indonesia's defeat in the United Nations Assembly on 29 November 1957, to pass a resolution in favor of Indonesia's claim to the territory. Sukarno responded by allowing the seizure of Dutch enterprises operating in Indonesia and announcing the intended expulsion of the Dutch residents from Indonesia. The increased tension surrounding the dispute encouraged the Dutch to accelerate their plans to move the dispute territory toward an act of self-determination. Elections were held across Netherlands, New Guinea in 1959, and the New Guinea Council officially took office on 5th April 1961 to prepare for full independence by the end of that decade. The Dutch endorsed the Council's selection of a new flag, anthem, and the Morning Star as the new flag on 1st December 1961. Following the raising of the Papuan national flag on 1st December 1961, tension further escalated. On 19 December 1961, Sukarno issued the Trikomando Rakyat, triple command of the Indonesian people, calling the Indonesian people to liberate the disputed territory before the conclusion of the 1962 all necessary means. In 1962, Indonesia launched a significant campaign of airborne and seaborne infiltrations against the disputed territories, beginning with a seaborne infiltration launched by Indonesian forces on 15 January 1962. The Indonesian seaborne infiltration was comprehensively defeated by Dutch forces. Forces to regroup. The Indonesians relaunched their campaign of infiltration in March 1962. In the coming months, over 500 Indonesian paratroops and special troops were covertly inserted into Netherlands, New Guinea, only to be decisively defeated by Dutch forces with the assistance of the indigenous population. Facing mounting international diplomatic pressure and the prospect of an Indonesia invasion force, the Dutch conceded to re-entering negotiation and agreed to the Ellsworth Bunker proposal on 28 July 1962 for a state transition from Dutch to Indonesia control via United Nations administration on the condition that a plebiscite would be held in the future in the territory. The agreement was signed on 15 August 1962 at the United Nations headquarters in New York, and the territory was placed under the United Nations Temporary Executive Authority in 1st October 1962. It was subsequently transferred to Indonesia in 1st May 1963. Over the next several years, it is estimated that 333,027 West Papuan were killed by the Indonesian military in a brutal silence of dissent. The territory was formally annexed by Indonesia in 1969 after the Indonesian government conducted an event termed the Act of Free Choice, which under strong pressure from the Indonesian military unanimously approved the annexation. Just 1% of the population was selected to vote, and those chosen were intimidated by security forces. This act of free choice has been strongly criticized by international community, including the group International Parliamentarian for West Papua, which has termed act of no choice. Since the Indonesian government has endorsed a policy of immigration by people from Java and other islands.
Deklarasi Umum Hak-Hak Asasi Manusia 1948 juga deklarasi PBB berikan kemerdekaan kepada negeri-negeri dan rakyat yang dijajah 1960 adalah sepenuhnya berikan hak-hak kepada rakyat yang wilayahnya tidak berpemerintahan sendiri secara oknum dan secara bangsa. Atas dasar dan uruf jiwa dari dokumen-dokumen ini, penolakan pemerintah Indonesia untuk melaksanakan sendiri dan sepenuhnya penentuan nasib sendiri di tahun 1969 kepada rakyat Papua dengan partisipasi PBB, ini adalah satu tindakan yang kontra dengan praktik internasional dan bertentangan dengan prinsip-prinsip yang tercantum dalam dokumen-dokumen ini.
The UN Charter, the 1948 Universal Declaration of Human Rights, as well as the United Nations Declaration on the Granting of Independence to Colonial Countries and Peoples, 1960s, fully safeguard the right of the people of non-self-governing territories, both as individuals and as nations. On the basis of the letter and the spirit of this document, the refusal of the Indonesian government to implement a proper and completely free act of self-determination in 1969 to the people of West Papua with the participation of United Nations Organization is an act contrary to the international practice and contrary to the principles of the above-mentioned document.
In many respects, the West Papuan struggle is a story of many indigenous peoples all over the world, that of exploitation. West Papuans, as you mentioned, are ethnically Melanesian and geographically a part of Oceania. So this seems to show that the Jakarta's claim for sovereignty over the region is just one of convenience. Because importantly, the world's largest gold mine, third largest copper mine, and several rich mineral deposits are located in West Papua. So this brings me to my first question to you. Following the presidential elections in July in Indonesia, there has been timid hope that the new president, Jokowi, being the first president not related to the military and the traditional elite, would actually give more attention to the case of West Papua, including through dialogue with Papuan leaders. But given the importance, economical importance that West Papua has to Indonesia, do you think that the leadership is really ready for such dialogue? Or do you think that this is just an empty promise that is foreseen to be failed? And my second question related to your organization. Since part of the leadership is based in West Papua and another part, including yourself, is based in other places of the world, including in Europe, how do you coordinate your independence struggle? And also, because of the restrictions on media freedom and media access in West Papua, how do you make sure that information actually reach the international community and spread around the world? Thank you.
Baik, saya akan mencoba menjawab dua pertanyaan saudari. Pertama, menyangkut janji dari Presiden Indonesia kepada rakyat Papua, kami pemerintah nasional di luar, saya tidak bisa melihat itu sebagai satu harapan yang akan kami capaikan. Tetapi kami akan lakukan sesuai dengan rencana kami menurut apa yang kami lihat akan menguntungkan kami.
Thank you for the questions. As a national government, we see the new elected Indonesian president will not change the Indonesian policy toward West Papua because of the natural resources and the others. According to the news that we got it from back at home, he can offer to the Papuan people everything they wanted, but not independence. So for West Papuan struggle, that's what we have proposed. If New World Summit, UNPO, and the other international organization can bring us, the national government of Republic of West Papua, representing West Papuan people, and Indonesian government to sit in the United Nations to solve the problem. Because one thing, Indonesia have a theater that they call Peace Dialogue Jakarta Papua. This is not the interest of the West Papuan people. This is the interest of the Jakarta regime.
So kami sendiri tidak dilibatkan di dalam dialog tersebut. Indonesia yang melibatkan orang-orang atau pihak dia yang ada relasi, baik politik dan sebagainya.
Because the national government was not involved in this peace dialogue Jakarta Papua. Because he chose the people that he wanted.
Saya mencoba pertanyaan yang kedua. Organisasi yang ada di Papua, yang ada di luar ataupun ada di dalam. Oleh sebab itu langkah-langkah yang kami akan ambil, salah satu contoh yaitu kami akan meregistrasi secara baik. Sebab kami juga memerlukan kapasitas baik manusianya dan juga hal-hal yang ada hubungan untuk mendukung pergerakan kami. Kami mempersiapkan satu negara dari luar yang sebentar kami bawa kembali ke negeri kami. Maka itu ini sebagai satu latihan, exercise kami selama di luar negeri untuk mempersiapkan manusia Papua yang bisa membangun negeri itu sendiri. Sebab Indonesia sudah tanamkan korupsi dan sebagainya terhadap orang-orang Papua sendiri. Maka itu kami melalui deregistrasi adalah suatu cara mengontrol bangsa kami yang mau terlepas dari Indonesia.
Come to the second question about the communication. We have, since the struggle we have started, I was young when I entered to the jungle after the colleagues, 1968, we formed a clandestine communication throughout the country and also to abroad. We have clandestine communication that we still use it, this method, for have correspondence between our leaders in abroad and our leaders in the country.